Resigned Information and Communications Undersecretary Eliseo Rio joins us on the line. Sir, thank you for taking our call.
Well, thank you for inviting me. How are you? Good morning.
Good morning, sir. Sir, can you tell us what prompted this this sudden resignation of yours?
Well, actually, I've been with the government offices for since I was second lieutenant, and I'm 75 years old. I thought that it would be now, well, finally to really spend more time with my family, no? So that is the main reason of my resignation. And of course, the working environment in the ICC has changed. Secretary Nasan had brought in talented young people, and maybe they should be given more chance to work on. In other words, I feel that I'm no longer needed in the ICC.
Okay, sir, was there any complication within the agency that prompted this resignation? Because there have been reports because of a certain issues over a certain intelligence fund. Can we get your reaction to this?
You are coming garbled. You mentioned about?
Sir, were there any issues within the bureau that prompted this resignation of yours?
Actually, that is the main reason, no? And of course, Secretary Nathan also knows that there were some, people in these new people that I could not work together with, no? So I said, I know that will give them the chance and then give them, well, Secretary Nathan free hand, no? Without any interference from my part.
Okay, thank you for clarifying that, sir. Now, has the president accepted your resignation?
Not yet. That's why I could not really come up with more details on the resignation until the president accepted it, or, well, it is his pleasure on how he will act on my resignation.
Okay. Now, when will this be enacted? When will the your last day be?
I could not really get you. I'm sorry. That's why you need an improvement in our telecommunication. Can I have that again, please?
Okay.
Hello?
Sir, can you tell us when will this resignation be effective?
Well, it will be effected on the exact time that the president will accept it.
Okay. All right.
And then I can go free. But before that acceptance, I could not really leave my post because, that will be abandonment.
Okay. Can you also tell us about your opposition to an alleged anomalous intelligence fund based on a COA audit?
Oh, yes. That was in the news, no? And I said that I have no first-hand knowledge on whatever anomaly that the reporter, you know, that did not come from me. What I said, and I think this was the basis of the their conclusion, what I said is that as far as I'm concerned, DICT does not need any confidential or intelligence fund because it is not in its mandate to conduct intelligence activities, no? So, of course, Secretary Nathan has other entities, his privilege, no? As the secretary, no? He needs confidential fund. But as far as I'm concerned, I never asked for any confidential fund.
Okay, so this fund is entirely unnecessary. Sir, can you tell us, what are the top three biggest challenges of the DICT?
I'm so sorry, no, I could not.
Okay, what are the biggest, top three biggest problems of the DICT that the next successor will have to weather through?
I really do not understand.
Okay, all right. Thank you for your time this morning, Mr. Eliseo Rio.
Yes, I'll keep you informed, no, if any development, no?
Thank you for that. Former DICT Secretary, well, not just yet, resigned former DICT Secretary Eliseo Rio.